That's Penny for me. Penny was from heaven for me, because Penny was the go-between between the practitioner, the person at the coal face, and those who pondered in academy, in academia. And that was so special because she made me believe in myself, that when I intuitively wanted to play and do things like that, she would say, yeah, that's okay. Providing at the end of all that, you come out with a youngster who wants to move on. And she used the word playful. And what I'm going to do with you now is play with you to remember Penny. So we're going to play for 9 minutes. Okay. Okay. When I start with my youngsters, and I also work with people with Alzheimer's, people in the 90s, I have magic. And then we're going to go, oh, anticipate, anticipate. Oh, my goodness me. And we have just a little bit of magic. Magic. So that's it. Playfulness. That's what our youngsters need. And I make myself a little bit different. Okay, oh, hang on, didn't go. And you all look like, that's brilliant, because the best thing about playing is you can make mistakes and kids learn from that. You don't thought, what's she doing? Okay, right. Okay. They come from China. They are banned in the UK, so don't get any. And I had pennies from heaven, and now I've got bubbles from heaven. Bubbles from heaven. But specially selected, because it's got a light in it. It's ones you can catch and play with, and you can work it yourself. So isn't that just wonderful? But, you know, to play playful. Those go across the age range. Wonderful bubbles. Wow. And I have umbrellas from heaven, because I can take youngsters into a playful world. They can make choices. They can play. They can become something different. So these are from the market. I'll give you a choice. We'll have a popular opinion vote. Whoa, robins from heaven. Look at that. Wonderful. Choose a robin. But then, and Les Stairs will love this because I give choice. One of one. Wonderful. Absolutely super. Number two. So I've got choice. I've got two worlds, a world of robins, a world of reindeers to play under, to have a wonderful time. But I have one youngster there who does not want to play, so I have to make personalised work for that youngster. Penny will tell you, you can't just do that en masse, it has to be personalised. So I have a homemade umbrella. This was confiscated by Ryanair. And I did fight it. It did get on the aeroplane about 3 years ago. Every time they see me, they go, that bloody woman again. Okay. This goes under the sea. Are you ready? Now, anticipation. A one, a two, and a... Whoa. Ooh, wow. That's better than robins. Yeah, wonderful. I can take that youngster into a wonderful, magical, playful world. But you notice I'm enjoying myself too. That's the most important. You cannot pretend to play. It has to be real play. It really, really does. Oh, wow, there we go. Okay. Then I have objects of reference. Boring, you know. The cup means we're going to have a drink, and it's usually a plastic beaker. Oh, boring. Let's play. It's going to be playtime. And here we have a wonderful, wonderful object of reference. Playtime. Huh. And everybody looked at that and went, oh, playtime! What an amazing, amazing object to reference. There we go. Okay. And boring old things like tying of shoelaces, you know, Velcro, but then we go on to tying of shoelaces. I've got a wonderful pair to try on, you know, really super duper. These one of my own shoes. And then I'm going to make them very special. Anybody want to learn to tie shoelaces? You're going to go for that, aren't you? It's not boring anymore. It's wonderful. It is playful. It is playful. Then we get to the serious stuff. Literacy, emergent literacy. All kids know to read what those are. Come on, what are they? Pringles. So your first letter of the alphabet is going to be a P for Pringles. But then I give them an unexpected surprise, which is playful, because when I shake it, whoa, woof, and when I shake this one, is it going to be the same or different? See all the vocabulary that's coming in here. Wonderful. Just did this. This took a gin and tonic to make the other night. You ready? This is for Penny. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. And then you've got to put back in again, which is even harder. You know, really, really. I'm not going to do it now, but there you go. My goodness me. Wonderful. And then we move into real books. Real books. And I know the vocabulary all my grandchildren and great-grandchildren love. This is the vocabulary they snigger at. These are the ones they do behind the bike shed. When you're special, you don't get to go behind the bike shed and be silly and funny and what have you. So one of the books I use is Poo Bum. So I get to use flashcards like this. Poo Bum. And there he is. There's my Poo Bum. And then I get to use words like, you ready? Now, who wants to, again, you want to read that book, don't you? It's by a New Zealand writer, so there you go. And we have a New Zealander in the audience. Right. Cause and effect. Hiding, disappearing, and appearing. All those things when you've got very special kids and adults that you work with. So I'm going to do the invisibility cloak of Harry Potter. You ready? I can see, I can't see. Oh, where am I? Everybody, everybody, where are you? Oh, here I am, here I am. How do you do? There we go, just pure magic. I'm being playful, I'm enjoying myself too. Okay. Just one more, let me step it out. One of my reading books, IKEA Whisks. IKEA Whisk book. Because when you're little and a baby in that sort of level of thinking, you like to shake things. So I have hundreds of things you can shake and read. This one's about autumn. So a wonderful, wonderful special book. So that's Penny for me. She gave me the privilege of being able to be playful and to work with children and adults and play and encourage them to move on to great academic things like reading Poo Bum books. I mean, what more can you ask for? Really super. And now, this is the finale. And I do apologise now because I came on Eurostar yesterday and I got to the little booth in Calais and there was the customs and all that sort of thing. And I was there with my little bag and two sniffer dogs came up and attacked me. And this is the reason why. Because I had in my bag certain things, and this is one of them. I'm going to finish now for Penny. And this is not pennies from heaven. It's not bubbles from heaven. It's actually confetti from heaven. And it's a bomb. So when these dogs attacked me, they were quite right. I had three bombs in my bag. I thought, it's going to make the news of the world, you know. And three bombs, and they took two away and let me keep this one for pennies. Can I explain? I'm not going to give you up these three bombs. You can have two. So they've gone off in this big black box, and they're in Calais being analysed, but I have got this one. Are you ready? Now you've got to do 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 for me. Are you ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.